G'day, it's Clayton from Planet Canada here. Today we're going to talk about how we can add or import a texture into our cabinet vision, which is super handy to do because when we are drawing up our jobs and maybe we're rendering them in 3D, it's fantastic to see all of the colors, all of the materials, how they would work together in a real world setting. And it really helps us bring our projects to life when we can see those textures on those parts. So it's super easy to do, it's very simple. If we want to import a texture, we go to our material manager. And then from the material manager, you can see we have the texture manager at the top, we click on him. From there, we can, to the left-hand side, create, arrange, sort all of our textures according to the different folders where we might want to store them. For me, I've created this test folder here. If I want to create a new folder, I could just click on it there and rename it however I see fit. But with this test folder, once I've got him highlighted in gray, I can then click on the import image to import an image into that folder. And then I want to click on the load an image from a file button. So I'll click on that and then I can just find where I've stored my texture. And theoretically, you could have as many different textures stored in that folder for your reference for importing all at once in Cabinet Vision. If I switch to the JPEG view, I can see the lime green JPEG that I have saved and that I would like to import into Cabinet Vision. So I can click on him and open, and voila, we can see I've got my bright green texture ready to go. So in the name and the description, I can add some of the features that I might want to reference in the program. The name could just be the name of the texture. It could just be perhaps the code of the material that is easy for us to find. And the description, maybe that could be the code there too. Or perhaps we might want to use, say, by example, the name of the vendor. Because both of these fields, the name and the description, we can search up here on the left so that we can find them easier when we are associating these textures with our materials. So now I've got the name and the description set. You can see there are also two options here that I don't have to tick. But if I did want to, the tile option, if it's enabled, it will ask Cabinet Vision to continually repeat the texture according to the specified world size. So if I click on him there, now I could create the world size, the world width, the world height, so that when that size is met, it begins to repeat the pattern. If I don't have that ticked, it will just be a grayed out. The decal, if I enable decal, it will instruct Cabinet Vision to blend the finish with the texture. But I don't have to have them ticked. I could leave them like that. And then I can click on OK. And my texture is imported, ready to be associated with the material. With the lime green there, I could also toggle between a list view. So maybe now if I had multiple different textures in this folder, I could sort between them using the different columns and change the order they appear in. And if I wanted to search for a material, it's here where I could search the lime green and find what I've added. So now if I click to close and I, under my test, maybe I could change him to be a lime green MDF. I could click twice on my material and now it's here under the texture, what I could change that texture to reflect the lime green that I have just added, like so. And there you go, it's as easy as that.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision power user.